for my next video, I'd like to do one on the Radiacode, and I specifically have the 110 version. This will work for all of them, the 102, 103, 103G, 101, forgot about that, and the 110. And this is the mapping feature. Now, I'm going to make this a two-part video, because I'm known to babble for a while sometimes, and then I get off target. So I want this video just on the mapping feature. Then the next video will be on what's called the radiaverse, where you can take your map tracks, upload them to this universal radiaverse website where everybody puts their tracks, and you can see where there's hot spots, and it shows the entire world. So it's really a neat, if you're into radioactive stuff and making it a hobby, this just leveled it up 10 steps. So anyway, let's get into it here. I want to show you the map feature first. I did two tracks in the map already. So we'll go off those. I'll show you about those, how to do those. And then the next video will be how to upload those and put them in the radioverse, and then a little bit about that. So let's get right in, as I said already. So on the main screen, you want to hit the three hamburgers and you want to go to map. Okay. And then this will show your map. Okay. So I've already done this. So there's my map view. It ticks, and it's a predetermined, you can set it. I want to say it does 10 a second, maybe a little bit. 10 is a number I can remember. I'm probably wrong, but you can set that anyway. So here you'll see my two tracks. One track I have 147 points, 1.05 miles. Another one I have 156 points at 159 miles. So what it's doing is, we'll just zoom in, and you can see as, now granted I was in my vehicle, you're probably not going to get the best reading while you're in your vehicle driving at 25, 30 miles an hour. But it still should heat up if you've got any hot spots. But as you can see, it takes a point everywhere you go. So, and then if you want, you tap on the point and it'll tell you where and what I was at. Hang on here. At this particular time, August 5th at 2:49, I was hitting 3.36 microrads an hour. 5.66 CPS, counts per second, and an accuracy of plus to 10 meters. So it's pretty accurate. Tap on menu. So I can attach a picture of that exact spot if I want to. I can delete the point or obviously cancel. So if for some reason you get a really, really hot spot and it's not really hot, you know, your reader, your Radiacode can be reading incorrectly, then obviously you might want to delete that so it will tell you right. So okay, so let's do this. Let's go over some of the settings. So the round circle, first off, we have counts per second. I can toggle it between counts per second and then the actual gamma reading. I have my three dots for menu. Now this is where you want to do a share track. Now you can do this a bunch of different ways. And again, this is an Android. I'm using a Samsung S25 Ultra. So the Apple, I know, is way different. They're according that from what I've read, the web, the app itself is not as in-depth as the Android version. So it may be different for you. Again, this is the Android version. so you want to share. After you're done with your track, you'll share it. And these are your tracks. And I can record again. I can tap on it. I can open it on the map. I can share the track, rename, edit, delete, track information. I can put a picture with each track, or you can select multiple tracks. So that's the way you do the tracks. To do a new track, you'd obviously go to, we'd want to do a new track. So right here, the track up at the top right here, the plus sign, that's how to start a new track. So you can have endless tracks on what you've done. So I name them, like, one time I went to the gas station, one time I went to McDonald's. Yeah, don't judge shitty food, but yeah, anyway, thought maybe there'd be some radioactive beef there or something. There wasn't. So anyway, that's the two tracks I have on the 5th and the 6th of August 2025. So anyway, on here we have the settings. These are all the different settings you can have. Markers. Here we go. Map auto. Oh, okay. That's map auto centering. So every 10 seconds, it'll try to center. Options. Show traffic. So if I had traffic, I live in a small city, so it's not going to show traffic, but that's for map settings. Then we actually have the tracks. That's the track icon. We have center on where you're at. So that's where I am right now. So it's centering in on me. The white circle is how to start and stop the track. So if you've gone to where you want to go and you're done tracking, you just hit that and it stops. And then again, I've told you this is the gamma reading or counts per second reading. And then we have the select, share track, track information, track picture. So you can actually put a picture to each track, or each point you can add a picture. So it's really in depth. I mean, when they thought this out, they really did a job on this. So this is really neat to have tracks. And then it gets even better yet, because soon I will, at my next video, I'll show you the radiaverse, which you can see. And you know, the first place I went was Chernobyl. So you can see the hot spots in Chernobyl. You can see, you know, all kinds of neat stuff. But anyway, this is how you do this. The last thing I want to discuss is how to move the tracks, because I'm on my phone. I take my phone with me. I do everything. I don't suggest doing the Radiaverse on your phone. Use a tablet, use a computer, use something with a big screen. There's a lot going on. So with that said, you want to go to this and you want to move these tracks to your tablet. So there's a million ways you can do it. For me, I do share track. I hit OK. Then at the bottom, I air share it, air tag, whatever you call that, to my tablet. So it automatically goes into my tablet. So I don't want to do it because that's part of the second video. Plus, I've already done it. Okay, so any questions, as always, put them in the comments down below. That is your basic video on how to do the map feature and how to map out sections of where you're at and show the hot or coldness of the radioactiviness of where you're at. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time, and until next time, I'm out.